My name is Stephanie Olofsson, and we're really glad that you're tuning in to us today. This presentation is for UIC, or University of Illinois at Chicago. A little bit about myself. I'm an admissions counselor here at UIC. I graduated in 2011 with my degree in psychology, and I graduated this past spring with my master's in social work, so I'm familiar with quite a few aspects of UIC as a whole, but where I get kind of rusty is what it's like to be a current student here. So for that, I have a current student with me joining me today. If you want to introduce yourself?
Yeah. Hi, my name is Gwen. I'm going to be a senior this year at UIC. My major is teaching of history, and in the past years I commuted. I just took the CTA Blue Line to and from, but this year coming up I will be living in campus housing, so I'm really excited for that.
So just a little bit of structure for what we have planned for today. So we're going to go over sort of like early orientation, housing, your commuting options, what your first 2 weeks are going to look like, and then just kind of student life in general. And then that's going to take about maybe 30 minutes or so. And then the last 30 minutes, we're actually going to open to you guys for questions. So if you guys have any questions for us, you do have a questions box that you can type in, and we'll be reading and answering those questions throughout the presentation, but primarily at the end as well. So just a little bit about UIC orientation. So you guys have been accepted. Congratulations. That's awesome. We're really, really excited to see you guys here in the fall. Orientation is kind of the one of the steps that you have to take in order to get here. And so at orientation, you guys will actually be meeting with your academic advisors. You'll be registering for your classes, and you know, just kind of meeting the new freshmen, meeting all the new students, getting a more in-depth tour of campus, and just kind of seeing what UIC is all about. So I'm going to go ahead and ask Gwen to talk a little bit about what her experience at orientation was like.
So I had a really awesome experience at my orientation. It's basically you stay for 2 days and you sleep over in our residence halls, which was really fun, and it's really new, and it was really new and exciting for me. So yeah, first day, they basically just kind of like sit you down, you get into your group, you meet the people of your group. I loved everyone in my group. We ended up actually staying up really late at night talking and just getting to know each other, and it was a really good time. And they, you know, go through everything, financial aid. They did like a demo class, so what a lecture class is going to be like, and they actually had one of their professors that came back from doing her research, and she presented her research, which was really cool. So it's just kind of getting you ready for college, which was nice. You also take your ID picture, which was really awesome, and you get to, of course, pick your classes. So that was a little intimidating, but they laid it out. They basically, you know, showed you what you completed if you took AP credit, and, you know, what is good to take, you know, during your first semester, fall semester, and then also what you'll be looking at taking for the next semesters following that, which was really nice. So it wasn't too bad. And then you also, if you didn't already say you wanted to live in campus housing, or you're still thinking about it, well then, then they also give you that option too, and to sign up for campus care, which is the insurance. So just pretty much like that. And of course, you spend tons of bonding time with your group.
Yes, absolutely. And so orientation happens throughout the summer, but we actually want to encourage you guys to get as early of an orientation date as possible. We have, again, they start, I think actually next week is the first week of orientation, and then all throughout the summer. So the earlier the better, because it is first come, first serve when it comes to picking your classes. And so we definitely want you guys to be able to get as many classes that you want at the times that you want as possible. And so the best way to go about doing that would definitely be to make sure that you get the earliest orientation date as possible. We do have a question about orientation, and it looks like it's saying, how does orientation work for people who are not coming as freshmen? And so that would make you a transfer student, I'm assuming. And so for transfer students, orientation is one day, so you don't have to stay overnight. It's very similar structured in that you're going to meet with your academic advisor. They'll go over any credits that you have transferred to UIC or are planning on transferring to UIC. It's pretty straightforward. It's only a one-day process. You'll still get the in-depth tour. You'll still get kind of the welcoming package and everything with that, just without the overnight experience. So hopefully that answers your question. So moving on, we are Chicago's university, so we are right in the heart of the city. We're about a mile from the Sears Tower. I know it's the Willis Tower, but the true Chicagoans know that it'll always be the Sears Tower. And so the picture that you see on the slide there, the building in the very center of the slide that looks like a domino, that's actually kind of where UIC's campus is. So all the surrounding buildings that you see there, that's really UIC's main campus. And so we are right there, right close to the heart of the loop. There's endless things to do in the city, just as a student. There's lots of academic opportunities, networking events, internships that we'll go into a little bit later. But Gwen, what do you do in your free time, in the city?
I use the city to my full advantage. On a really nice day, occasionally I'll walk down with my friends. We're 2 miles away from the beach. We'll just walk straight through downtown and have a great day at the beach. They're shopping on Michigan Avenue. A lot of times, or at least during once a month, or even sometimes twice a month, a lot of the museums will have free days. And so I just love to go down and, see the new exhibits and look around. I love the Shedd Aquarium. It's a great exhibit museum to go in and see. So I'll go and do that. And then, of course, there's so much diversity just going in to different cafes with, during lunch hour is something that, is unique within itself to try and do. And it's really fun. And then, of course, there's going into Chinatown and just exploring downtown, which is nice.
Yeah, so that's like the city as a whole. And then just bringing it more towards more localized as to where we are. So this slide shows kind of our campuses. So we have two primary campuses, which are East Campus and West Campus. We have a South Campus as well, but we've been kind of including that in our East Campus just because it's so close together. And East Campus is primarily where you'll be spending the bulk of your time as an undergraduate. And then West Campus is more of our medical district. So if you're interested in medicine or are in a graduate program for medicine or anything medical related, that's kind of where you'd be centered. But for undergrad, all undergrad programs, they're primarily on East Campus. So that's really where you'll be. And then you'll notice some of the fun, vibrant neighborhoods that we have just kind of surrounding our campuses. We have Chinatown, Pilsen, Little Italy, Greek Town. There's so many awesome food options, but it's also a great place if you're choosing to maybe live off campus and you want to live in an apartment off campus. That's completely fine. We don't require any students to live on campus at any point. And so if you wanted to get an apartment in any of those fun neighborhoods, that's definitely what a lot of our students choose to do. However, if you do choose to live on campus, which I actually think is a really awesome option, we do have 10 different residence halls that you can choose from. We have our West Campus halls, and those are the single student residence, the Polk Street residence, and the student residence halls. We have our East Campus residence halls, which are Commons West, Courtyard, Commons North, and Commons South. And then we have our South Campus / East Campus halls, which are the Thomas Beckham Hall, Marie Robinson Hall, and then James Dougal Tower, or JST as it's more commonly known. I lived on campus my first 2 years that I was here. I loved it. It was a great way to kind of establish connections, feel kind of more connected to the UIC campus as a whole, which was really, really nice. I really, really loved that experience. But Gwen is perfect example of somebody who can also live off campus and still thrive. And so do you want to maybe talk a little bit about your commuting experience as well?
So because I just, my house is not that far from the CTA Blue Line. So during the day, and especially on weekends, just coming in, and because UIC is so close and so very much towards the middle of, you know, downtown the city of Chicago. You know, it was really easy just to go places with friends, especially on the weekends. It's a great tool to, you know, just go from job to job, because for me, everything was so close. And even if it, you know, was in Chicago, you know, more towards the downtown area of Chicago, you know, I could just hop on a bus or even just take the train a couple of stops, and it was right there. So yeah, even though commuting, you know, you have to put in time for it, still, you still have plenty of time to get around and have fun.
Yes, and we have a question actually about housing, and it says, can I enroll for housing after my first year at UIC?
Oh, yeah.
The answer is absolutely yes. You can live on campus at any point, and Gwen actually is going to be living on campus next year. So she chose to commute for her first 2 years, and now she's going to live on campus. So absolutely, at any point, if you want to live on campus, you absolutely can. The priority deadline for that is March 15th, but we definitely will still accommodate late applications and anything like that as well. Just getting around UIC or the city in general, we give you guys, it's formerly known as a U-Pass, but now it's the Venture Card. And what it is it's a card with your picture on it, and it gives you unlimited access to all CTA buses and trains 24/7, starting the week before classes start and ending the week after classes end. So throughout the whole semester, you kind of have unlimited access, which is super awesome. And it's included in your tuition. So it's free to students. It's pretty nice. We are a very bike-friendly campus. We're a very bike-friendly city nowadays. We have our Divvy bikes all throughout the city, and you can check those out. You can ride them all over campus. You can ride them all over the city. We do have parking available to students who want to bring cars. We don't require cars. There's no limits on who can bring cars. It's about $360 a semester, though, so it's pretty pricey for parking, and that's just because we have those CTA bus and train passes. You have, you know, lots of bike options, walking, all of that. And so there's lots of options for you. We're about a mile away from Union and Ogilvie stations, so a lot of students who are commuter students end up taking the Metro trains. We have a UIC iCarpool, and so what you can do is you can go and you can find somebody through this website who is also another UIC student who's maybe commuting from the same place that you are, and if you guys want to carpool together, that can kind of be put together, which is pretty nice. And so for housing, we have a question, how much was housing? Housing is about $10,000 per year, but it's if you look at it compared to an apartment price or anything like that, it's pretty similar in pricing. And it's, you know, you have heat and air included, you have cable, you have internet access, you know, the whole works there. So it's pretty nice. And that also includes meal plans. And so you have unlimited meals. You can either choose a 5-day or 7-day meal plan. And you can swipe in as many times a day as you want, eat as much as you want. So be aware of that freshman 15. That's not a myth, but we do have an awesome gym too to combat that. So absolutely. We also have a question of when are placement tests due. So placement tests, actually, you can do them right now. We encourage you to do so. You just need to make sure that they're done before you come to orientation. Okay. So when you come here also, so something to look forward to is convocation. And convocation happens the day before classes start. And what that does, it's kind of just a big, huge ceremony to pump you guys up to start the year off right and start your career here at UIC off right, which is really fun. Gwen, do you want to talk maybe a little bit about your experience with convocation?
Sure. At my convocation anyway, they first kind of sat you down in our pavilion, which is our main gym. That's also where our basketball team has all their home games. And so everybody graduating in your class sits down on the main floor. Your parents are in the stands. And then you have a lot of people come and talk, you know, congratulate you again on getting accepted into UIC. Generally speaking, you do kind of sit with what college you're in, but even that can kind of get mixed, but that's okay. And then they just kind of have this whole like show. They have the cheerleaders and the dance team there. And they even had someone come in with like a flame and just kind of ignites a candle. So it kind of shows that, you know, you're starting your flame and then you're going to continue that until you graduate. And then afterwards, it's free food, free things. I had so many free things. If you wanted a tour of campus, you got to see that. It was a really fun time. You also got to sign your name on a banner, and that was what class you would be graduating in. And that's really fun, and they actually hang that up in our student center too.
Yeah, so definitely Convocation's awesome. A lot of people get super pumped up with it. So that's something to look forward to as well. We have another question, and it's, do we have a tennis team? And if so, is there a scholarship attached to that? We do have a tennis team. Actually, all of our sports here are Division I sports. We're the UIC Flames. It's pretty awesome. And yes, you can get scholarships through any of our sports. And so I would recommend contacting the coach. And so that, if you go to our website at uic.edu and you click on athletics, you can find your respective coach for whatever sport it is you're interested in, and then you can maybe reach out to them and have a conversation about them either coming out and scouting you, or you know, kind of what your options are with scholarships and making the team. So hopefully that answers your question. So we're going to transition now just kind of about classes and what to expect within the first couple of weeks of class. And so within the first 2 weeks, so first day of class this year is August 25th, 2014, which is sooner than we think. So that's crazy. Within those first 2 weeks of classes, you guys are going to kind of get to know your schedules. You're going to really, you know, understand kind of like what it's like to be a college student and transitioning into that. We have our involvement fair on campus, and what that is basically we have over 300 student organizations here on campus, so we have quite a few, and they will set up booths in our quad, and you guys can kind of walk through, see what we have to offer, and you know, kind of choose things to get involved in. And so my piece of advice to any student who's new is to get involved in at least one thing while you're here. It's amazing how much that will make you feel more connected to UIC. You can meet more friends that way. It looks great on a resume. Lots of networking opportunities can come from it as well. We have anything stemming from athletic to you know, academic, religious, volunteer organizations. We have fraternities and sororities. We have you know, all kinds of things to get involved in. And so definitely we want to challenge you guys to get involved in at least one thing while you're here. We have our annual welcome week. So the first week of class, you know, it's welcome week. So that means all these organizations and, you know, all the support programs that we have on campus and everything like that, they kind of come out, they give you a lot of free things. Lots of free things happen the first week of class. And so that's really, really exciting, because when you are a poor college student, you understand, you always appreciate the free food, you appreciate the free t-shirts and everything like that as well. So it is a good time. Spark in the Park. So every year we have some artists come and perform for us for free. We've had Lupe Fiasco, we've had Kid Cudi, you know, we've had, you know, so many different kinds of artists come in and give us free performances. And so all you need is your UIC ID to get into the concert. And it's held in our Harrison Field, which is one of the parks that we have on campus. And so that's a wonderful time, definitely. I've always enjoyed going to those as well. We have another question, and it's asking, do we have a female volleyball team? And yes, we do. We do have female volleyball. We have a whole list of male and female sports if you want to go to the website again, uac.edu. And if you click on the athletics tab, it can give you a list of all of the different sports, men and women's, that we offer here. So we are a very team effort focused university, and so what we want to do is make sure that you guys are as supported as possible. We understand that the transition from high school to college is sometimes a little bit rocky, just in that, you know, you don't have the teachers seeking you out if you, you know, don't do so well in a test or a quiz or homework or anything like that. You know, you you're not going to have the teacher come up to you and be like, oh, you know, what happened? In fact, you have to take it upon yourself to go and say, hey, you know what, I'm not understanding this. You know, what can I do to improve? And so what you can do is utilize any one of our resources that we have on campus. And these are the list right here is just a few of those. Gwen, do you want to maybe talk about what you've utilized as a student here?
Sure. So in the past, I've used the Writing Center. The Writing Center is one of our really excellent resource centers. Basically, you make an appointment. It's one-on-one, so it's you and the tutor. And you take in maybe a paper for history or English. It could even be a science lab report. It could even, you know, just be a couple ideas and even resumes and cover letters. Anything that you've written, you can take it in, they'll look over it, they'll, you know, proofread it, make corrections. But what's really good is that it's up to you to go back and make those corrections to help you understand what you're seeing wrong, which is actually a really good way to kind of correct how you're writing. And their motto is a great hire, and it's held true so far. So they know what they're doing. Pros there. And I've also used the Math Learning Center and the Science Tutoring. Both are kind of similar, where it's just basically all day tutoring from 8 to 5. Normally, your tutors are going to be teacher assistants that are there for maybe an hour or for 4 hours. So basically, no matter what subject or no matter what level of math or science you're taking, you can just go in there and you can receive tutoring. You usually receive a schedule in 2 weeks' time from your professor. So you can go in right as soon as you get that and see who you want as your tutor. A lot of the time, since your tutors are going to be your teacher assistants, when it comes time for those midterms or finals, these tutoring hours could be great test preparations. And you can have that quick touch up of, you know, maybe what you forgot, maybe what you don't quite understand. And things like that, which is really helpful. And what's nice about the Math Learning Center is that they have their own textbooks. And if you're struggling on a certain concept that, you know, you kind of learned back in high school or you never were taught, the TAs will, or the teacher assistants will work with you. They'll give you worksheets, they'll reteach you, and they'll basically have you come out knowing what you didn't know before, which was really nice.
Yes, absolutely. So we have a ton of different options, you know, for pretty much every subject area that we have here at UIC. We definitely have support for you. And it looks like we have a couple more questions. The first question is, how close is the gym from Courtyard if you walk? And also, are the classes close to the dorms? So from Courtyard, for the gym, I'd say it's what, like 2,000 feet away. It's literally a 2-minute walk. So it's right there. Many of the Courtyard rooms, their views are of the gym. So it's very, very close. The classes themselves, if you live on East Campus, they're right there. So like I said earlier, most of your classes are on East Campus. So if you're living in Courtyard, you can roll out of bed and be in class in 2 minutes. If you're on West Campus, it's probably about maybe like a 20-minute ride to class. So from your dorm to the classroom, it's probably about 20 minutes. From South Campus, it's probably about maybe like a 5 to 10-minute walk. So it's pretty, everything's still pretty close. But definitely East Campus, it's the closest to the classes. So if that's what you're interested in, definitely that's a good choice. We have another question, and it says, are the classes ever lecture halls, or are they mostly classroom? That's a really, really good question. So at UIC, about 30% of our classes are 20 or fewer students, with 83% of our classes being 50 or fewer students. So we do have a lot of really small classes. The largest lecture that we have on campus is 450 students, and so that's pretty big. Anytime that we have a lecture that's over 150 students, we're always going to break down into a discussion group. And so kind of the way that's structured, if you have that class 3 days a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, Monday and Wednesday might be spent in like your 250-person lecture, and then Friday would be spent in your 20-person discussion section going over everything you learned in lecture that week. And so that's kind of how we're structured here. That's more freshman and sophomore level classes. Whereas, you know, when you reach junior and senior year, your class sizes do dwindle down significantly just because you're more in your major classes. So the bigger classes are usually more gen ed class, and then the major classes are the smaller classes. Would you say that that's kind of how your experience has been?
Yeah, very much so.
Okay, so. Yep, mine as well. And psychology, I was a psychology major, and that's actually the second most popular major on campus. So to say that my smallest class size, I was actually the only student in one of my classes, but the average class size was about 20 students for me with that. And then it looks like we have another one. It says, how often can someone of the same gender sleep in your dorm room per week? So visitors in the dorms, you, as long as your roommate's okay with it, you can have up to 2 visitors per night in the dorm room. But again, your roommate does have to be okay with it if you're living with somebody. Okay. So another special opportunity that we have here is study abroad. I cannot stress enough how awesome study abroad is. I went to London when I was a student here for a summer. You guys can go for a summer, a semester, an entire year. That's completely up to you. You can go pretty much anywhere in the world that you want to go. I had a friend who went to Fiji for a semester. He literally had classes on a white sandy beach and the best tan I've ever seen. So it's pretty awesome. We don't have a language requirement, so the classes that you take overseas can actually be taught in English. You guys can go with UIC professors, you can go with UIC students. If you guys know of another program with another school, you can join in on that as well. So it's really up to you. You guys can stay in dorms, you can stay in homestays, you can get your own apartments. You know, there's a lot of flexibility with that. And so that's definitely something that I'm going to recommend to every single one of you guys to take advantage of. No matter what your major is, if you plan accordingly, you can absolutely take advantage of study abroad. And so we are a learn by doing campus, and that's kind of like our motto. And so we're very hands-on here. We are a research one institution, which means that we're kind of at the forefront of the research world. Almost all of your professors are actively doing research in their fields. A lot of them encourage you guys to take advantage of, you know, the research that they're doing just by joining in at the undergraduate level. And so, I mean, for me, I did psychology research when I was a student here. I did memory and cognition labs, and I got credit for it towards graduation, which was really cool. And also looks really good on your resume. And so if you're interested in maybe like a graduate program or medical school or, you know, even in business or anything really, you know, definitely take advantage of the research. It's a great way to kind of network with your professors as well. Internship programs. Every student should get an internship. Like, just no matter where you end up, no matter what happens, get an internship, because that's definitely the best way to make sure that whatever it is that you're working for, towards your degree or, you know, whatever your specialty might be, that's actually the best way to make sure that that's actually what you want to do. So there's nothing worse than spending 4 years and hundreds of thousands of dollars towards a degree that, you know, at the end you're like, actually, I don't think I like this. So definitely take advantage of the internship opportunities. Do you want to talk maybe a little bit about how you are, what you do for internships or anything like that?
So the current job I have now is actually not really, well, it's kind of an internship, but it's also more my federal work study job. So I actually work in an actual Chicago public school. I'm a teacher, and depending on how long I've been with that teacher, because I've been basically working there for 3 years now, sometimes I even co-teach. And with that, it really helped me see the difference between what you think a teacher does as a student compared to what a teacher actually does being a teacher. And with that, it was a great experience. It still is. I'm still with it. And even though I'm not looking at working in a grade school level, definitely working in the upper grades helps me realize that, yes, I do want to teach high school after I graduate. So definitely that internship can help you see what you really do or don't want to do. I also had a volunteer opportunity where prior to being teaching of history, I started out as biology, pre-veterinary medicine, and I got to work in an actual veterinary clinic in one of the animal shelters downtown in Chicago, and it was great, but there were some parts that, you know, helped me realize that maybe this isn't for me. So, definitely getting that internship, whether it's paid or not, can definitely help you realize what you really want to do.
Absolutely. And so again, definitely take advantage of that. And any student who wants an internship can have one. Absolutely. We also want to encourage you guys to network with your faculty. I mean, with your professors. I have my personal story with that is I had an English professor that I really, really liked. And we were talking after class one day and I told her that, you know, I actually really wanted to, go to school for social work. And it turned out that one of her best friends was a social worker, over at Northwestern Hospital. And so she was like, hey, you know what, why don't you meet up for coffee with her? And I did. And so, and then I ended up using her as a reference later on. She opened up the door to some internship opportunities for me. And so, you know, even if your professor isn't necessarily in the field that you want to go into, chances are they know somebody who is. So definitely we want to encourage you guys to take advantage of getting to know our faculty here. We have a few more questions, actually. So the first question is, how much does study abroad cost? So I did not touch on that, so thank you. Study abroad, actually, we do a tuition match. And so you're never going to pay more for tuition overseas than you would for tuition here, which is an awesome deal. So really what you're paying for is travel expenses. And we have a lot of scholarship opportunities for students who want to take advantage of study abroad. We have an awesome study abroad office here on campus. So if you're really interested in study abroad, I would strongly encourage you guys to go and talk to them, usually about a year before you're planning on going, because it's an awesome experience and you can probably get it completely paid for if you do the lit work on that. So definitely do that. And then the next question is, can you apply for a study abroad at any point? And yes, you can. You cannot go your first semester of freshman year, and you cannot go your last semester of senior year. So anytime between second semester freshman year and first semester of senior year, you guys can go study abroad. And again, that can be for a summer, a semester, or an entire year. That's completely up to you. The next question is it mandatory to take a language in college, or can I test out of taking a language such as Spanish? So that's a great question, and that actually depends on your major. And so for liberal arts and sciences, for that college, any major that falls into that college, we do require 2 years of a foreign language. You can take a placement test, and if you are fluent in something, you can place out of that. But you would have to take the placement test for that. So the answer is yes. However, if you are in the business college, or I believe engineering as well, you don't have to take a language if you have at least 2 semesters in high school. So there's each college is different, each major is different. So definitely check with your academic advisor when you meet with them at orientation. Otherwise, definitely just go ahead and take that placement test to place out of that. The next question is, when can I start applying for an internship? It's never too late to apply for an internship, and that's the truth. So you guys can start applying, I would say wait till maybe sophomore year, but sophomore, junior, senior year. Junior and senior year are definitely the big times to take advantage of that, and do more than one internship too if you can, or if you can do a repeat internship like 2 summers in a row. Some majors actually allow you to have that internship during school, and you'll actually get class credit for it towards graduation. And so that again does depend on major, but it is a really great opportunity for you to do that. The next question is, do you guys have mostly paid internships? Oh, that's the magical question, isn't that? So we have some paid internships, some are not. Again, it really just depends. I know with engineering college does guarantee each student a paid internship. But, you know, if you're going to maybe, like for me, I did psychology, I did an internship. It was not paid, but they ended up hiring me on after graduation. And I actually did get to take that internship for credit towards graduation. Paid in different ways, but we do have a lot of paid internship opportunities, as well as some unpaid as well. And then the next question is, does biology require a language? Yes, it does. So biology does fall into our College of Liberal Arts and Sciences. So yes, it would require 2 years. Again, you can take a placement test to place out. And then we have another question. Are on-campus jobs promoted during welcome week? Yes, on-campus jobs are promoted always. There's so many perks to being just to have an on-campus job versus an off-campus job. Gwen, do you maybe want to touch on some of the perks? She's actually paid to do this, so this is her on-campus job.
So one of the great perks about having a job on campus is if you have a huge gap in between your classes, say if you have a class at 8 and then your next class isn't until like maybe 2, instead of just, sitting around not knowing what to do, you can go work for a couple hours, which is what, I do. Since you're on campus, you don't have to walk too far. Generally speaking, if you need time to, write that paper or to study for finals, generally speaking, your bosses are going to be a little bit more understanding because, that time of the semester has hit. Coming from not working on a job on campus, it definitely makes it easier, time management wise, less stress. And also, you get to know a lot of things on campus that you didn't know before. And definitely with the job I have right now talking to you guys, there's so many things I didn't know before, and now I do know. And it almost makes me feel so much closer to campus, and I know way more people than I did before.
Yeah, absolutely. So we do encourage students to seek out those on-campus jobs. We have an on-campus job fair every semester as well, and so look out for that. But yes, they will have promotions for on-campus jobs during welcome week, so do not worry about that. So I mentioned earlier that we have over 300 student organizations here on campus. And again, those range from all different types. And so definitely we want to encourage you guys to get involved. We do have a couple of annual traditions. We did talk a little bit about Spark in the Park and Involvement Fair, but we also have recess, which is so much fun. Basically, it's kind of what you see in the picture there. We have students just come together in the middle of our quad. We have sumo suits, bungee jumping things, free food, music, all that stuff. And it's just kind of a way for students to let loose and just kind of hang out. Usually it's around midterm, so students who need to kind of take a break, mental break, and just have fun. And so that's definitely an annual tradition that we look forward to. We also have Taste of UIC. So unfortunately, we don't have a culinary school here, but we do have a lot of students who are interested in the culinary arts. And so we have a ton of different clubs and also like cultural organizations just who have students who like to cook. And so we do have a Taste of UIC that's mirrored off of the Taste of Chicago. And it is a wonderful event if you like to eat, which I definitely do. And so it's a really, really good time. We also have our UIC fashion show. So any student who wants to participate in the fashion show absolutely can. We have local boutiques, we have some major department stores, we have just stores that anyone would recognize come and donate clothes and donate apparel to UIC for this fashion show, and it raises money for charity. So that's an annual thing, and that's something that we definitely look forward to as well. We have a whole bunch of professional organizations and conferences on campus. Again, we're really big with networking, so we definitely want to encourage you guys to network as soon as or as much as possible, and so definitely take advantage of that. So that's pretty much it for our portion of the presentation, and so now we're just going to kind of open up to you guys to take questions. So definitely feel free to keep those coming. We see a few already. The first question is, what happens if you fail the placement test? Oh boy. Well, then you'll be placed in remedial. So for example, if you failed the math portion, or if you don't do maybe as well as you'd like on the math portion, you would be placed into like math 090, which is a remedial math. And we would actually encourage you guys to take those placement tests as soon as possible, so that if you do place into something like that, you can do summer college. So UIC summer college is actually free to incoming students, and that is a place where you can take those remedial courses and not have to pay for them, versus when you come in the fall, if you have to take them, you're paying the tuition. So definitely I would encourage each one of you guys to take those placement tests. Yeah. Looks like we have another question. It says, I have my FAFSA loan available to me, and it says something about a sub and unsub loan, I believe. What does that mean? Okay, so subsidized versus unsubsidized loans. And for that, that's actually, so a subsidized loan versus an unsubsidized loan has to do with your payments, your payment plan and the interest that's generated on it. So I believe a subsidized loan is where you you take out the loan, you don't have to pay it back until about like 6 to 9 months after graduation, but it's acquiring interest while you are still in school, versus an unsubsidized loan where it does not require interest while you're still in school. So I think it just has something to do with the interest levels. And I would definitely recommend, if you have any questions about financial aid, to please feel free to contact our financial aid office. They are wonderful, and they will definitely be more than happy to help with you guys with anything related to financial aid. Let's see what else we got. The next question is, can I get an on-campus job prior to school starting? That's challenging. So you actually need to be a current student in order to work on campus. I would say your chances are that you're going to find a job within the first couple of weeks of school. I mean, just because every unit is hiring. Admissions, we're always hiring too. So come on over, and we'll be happy to interview you guys. The next question is, I was registered under the College of Engineering, but I have to be under the LAS colleges because my major is biology. What should I do? So I'm not sure what happened there. If you maybe applied to bioengineering, that might have happened. If you want to do biological sciences, or maybe if you changed your minds since you've applied, which happens all the time, that's completely fine. You guys can do what's called an intercollege transfer at any point here at UIC. And so basically what that means is, if you applied, you know, let's say you started out in engineering and you're like, you know what, this is really not for me. I'm not a fan. I don't think I want to do this anymore. And I really do want to go to LAS or any of the other colleges. What you do is you talk to your academic advisor. You explain that that's not what you want to do anymore. And then they'll set you up on a track so that you can do an intercollege transfer and then be recognized in that college. And so for you, what you should do right now would be to talk to your academic advisor at orientation and just explain that you don't want to be in engineering, you'd rather be in LAS. And then you guys can kind of go from there, and you can do that. Let's see. The next question is, what is the ideal amount of hours you recommend between school, a job, different clubs, and organizations? That's a great question. I applaud you, sir, for asking that question. So Gwen, do you maybe want to talk a little bit about your time management since you're the current student?
Sure. One of the first things I want to recommend is get a planner, because it'll definitely help you see how much time or how much stuff you need to do in a day. So, I mean, depending on how many classes you're taking, you know, it's definitely good to study each night. You know, maybe if it's an easier class for you, you know, maybe set aside, you know, half hour, maybe hour. If it's more difficult, you know, you're going to need to spend a little bit more time on studying that. And also with that, you know, you have to incorporate, you know, work. You don't want to overwork yourself, because school does come first. The reason why you're in college is to get an education, not necessarily to just work repeatedly. And with that, you know, balancing, you know, that study time, you know, do you want a daytime job as opposed to working at night, which is probably when you're going to study more? Or do you want to have a, you know, more nighttime job and then, you know, study during the day because you just focus more during the day? That is entirely up to you, but definitely not overworking yourself has been a struggle that I've gone through. And also on that, you know, you also have your organizations that you're a part of. Generally speaking, organizations meet once a week. So, you know, definitely one or two is fine. It's not going to be like high school where, you know, you can join like four and it's still okay. No, each organization is still going to require quite some time from you, especially if you're in a fraternity or sorority. That's going to require a lot of time. Knowing that, when you do get to UIC, when you set up your classes, you know, kind of need to lay out, you know, what works best for you, you know, during the day. are you a morning person for classes? And then you can filter in work during the day. And then generally speaking, club organizations meet at night. So maybe, you know, separate another hour for that. Or vice versa. Maybe you work better with evening or more afternoon classes, and then you can have the morning to study and stuff. And one of the nice things is that here at UIC, we have so many resource centers that offer time management. And one of those resource centers is the Undergraduate Success Center. And with that, they'll lay out, you know, your entire schedule before you, you know, what you do, what you want to do, what you plan on doing, and, you know, they'll help you with that, which is a great, great resource to have. So I would definitely recommend doing that because as a high school student and even sometimes transfer going into, you know, a big university, you're given all this freedom all at once.
Yeah, absolutely. So definitely good advice in there. And they say, you know, for every hour that you spend in class, you should spend 2 to 3 hours studying for that class. So the average college student takes about 15 credit hours. So that's like about 15 hours per week in class. So that's, you're looking at 30 to 45 hours of studying alone. And so, I mean, that's going to vary week to week based on, you know, exams and papers and whatever it is that you have going on. But definitely I would budget that much time into your week just for studying. The next question we have is, can you change your major at orientation? You can speak with your advisor about changing your major. You know, like I said earlier, you can change your major pretty much at any point at UIC. Some majors do require you to take certain classes in order to declare yourself as that major then. And so you might have to wait a semester and take those classes to put you on that track. But yes, you can change your major. And again, you would talk to your academic advisor at that point for that. The next question we have, are sports an everyday activity? Yes, they are. So we have Division I sports here, which are the major sports, but we also have intramural sports, we have club sports, and those happen all the time. And so some you have to try out for, some anyone can join. But yes, sports are happening all the time here on campus. The next question we have, where would you recommend searching for more scholarships? That's a great question. So I'm not sure if you are part of the Honors College or looking into the Honors College at all, but if you have a 3.4 GPA or higher, you can definitely apply to be in our Honors College. And that's really where the majority of our merit-based scholarships stem from. But, you know, outside of that, you know, scholarships.com, fastweb.com, actually what I found, which was surprising to everybody, was through my father's company, actually, he ended up having a scholarship at his company that I won, and it ended up paying for half of my tuition for all 4 years. And so I would recommend looking into your parents or, you know, guardians or even your own employment options for any kind of scholarships that you might have through that as well. So there's scholarships lurking in every corner. We have an office of special scholarships here on campus as well, and they have some of the more random scholarships. We have scholarships for being left-handed. We have scholarships for having red hair, for being a certain height, for, you know, all kinds of different things. And so definitely do the legwork on that. Look online, but look through our office, look through the Honors College, and it is a great opportunity for you guys to find some money. Let's see, the next question that we have, does theater or performing arts major require an audition? Yes, it does. So you would have to audition for that. The next question, is the class schedule available, or where can I find the classes that I need to take? So that's a good question. That's actually going to happen at orientation. And so, for you, you have to wait to meet with your advisor, and what the advisor will do is they'll sit down with you. They'll kind of map out not only your semester, but kind of they'll give you a rough idea for what's required of you for all 4 years. We do have a link on our website, so if you go to uic.edu and you click on the admissions tab, and under that, the undergraduate admissions, on the right-hand side of your page, you guys can have a link to our course book, and so that will outline kind of give you a rough idea for what is required of your major. And then for the class schedules, that's what you're going to schedule your classes at orientation with your advisor. So, okay. So we have about 10 minutes left. So if you guys have any other questions for Gwen or myself to answer, definitely please feel free to send them our way. So for those of you guys who are coming as incoming freshmen, again, we want you guys to get involved as much as possible. And it looks like we might have a theater and performing arts student interest. And so if that's the case, we do have a really, really good theater program here. And it's actually, they put on some really, really awesome shows. So for those of you guys who maybe aren't interested in being in theater, but watching it, it is a really, really great program that we have here on campus. And so I would definitely want to encourage you guys to do that. We have another thing on campus. It's called LOL. Do you want to maybe talk a little bit about what LOL is? Laugh Out Loud. Oh, you haven't participated? So Laugh Out Loud, we have comedians come and perform at UIC. We had like Kenan Thompson from Saturday Night Live, or for you 90s kids, from Kenan and Kel. He came and he performed for us live. It was really, really awesome. It's hilarious. So we have a whole bunch of different things that you guys can kind of take advantage of on campus, as well as off campus too. So looks like we have another question. Do I ask for scholarships at orientation? No, orientation is really geared more towards your classes and scheduling your classes and kind of, figuring out, you know, where you need to be and what you need to do, with scholarships. That's really happening right now. And so, you want to definitely be looking for scholarships before you come to UIC. And then even when you're here, and a current student, utilize our Office of Special Scholarships, utilize those internet websites, FastWeb, again, you know, scholarships.com. That's really kind of the primary thing. You also obviously hopefully would have filled out your FAFSA. And so you'll get your financial aid package and your financial aid awards letter. And that kind of details anything that we're going to give you for the first year. And then, you know, anything that you want to add to that additionally when you get here, again, that would be through Office of Special Scholarships or Honors College as well. The next question that we have is, I worked at my school that I attended before UIC. Does that help me when I go to apply? I'm not sure what the question is there. I mean, if you worked at your school, I mean, that it really depends, I guess, on what you were doing at that school, and kind of what role that would play at UIC from there. So if you want to maybe expand on that question a little bit, I'd be happy to answer it. Let's see, we have another question. To join the female volleyball team, are there any requirements? Yes, you have to try out. And tryouts are held usually in the first few weeks of school. But again, I would really, really encourage you to reach out to the coach. And you can find that contact information again on our website, uic.edu. And if you click on the athletics tab, you can find all the information about women's volleyball there. And then reach out to that coach, say, you know what, hey, listen, I'm really interested. You know, winter tryouts, what can I do? Anything like that. We have about 5 minutes left. So any final questions for us, and we're happy to answer. We have someone saying thank you. So you're more than welcome. We hope to see you guys here in the fall. You know, we'll sit here for, you know, maybe a couple more minutes. And we have one more question, it looks like. We have I was a peer career advisor at JJC, so I was curious, does having prior student worker experience help with getting a student worker job at UIC? Yes, absolutely. So, you know, if you want to get a student job on campus, any experience with a job will definitely help you, particularly with customer service or just anything in that sect. So definitely, yes, it will help you out. I hope that you have a current resume. So have that prepared, maybe for the first week of classes, so that you can pass that out to anybody who's looking to hire. Yeah, absolutely. We have another person who's saying thank you. You're more than welcome. Again, we hope to see you guys here on campus. We'll probably just wrap up now. So thank you again for tuning in. We're here to answer any questions that you might have. All of the contact information is right there. And thank you guys so much for tuning in. And we hope to see you here in the fall.